Voters across at least three states said they received threatening emails from an account posing as the right-wing group Proud Boys. Now, the emails had a chilling message: vote Trump or else. That's the message. The account also claimed that its handlers have access to voters' personal information and had already hacked the voting infrastructure to track their vote. So officials are investigating the voter intimidation attempt, including where the emails originated. Melissa Quinn has been working on this story for CBSNews.com. She is a CBSNews.com reporter and joining us now. This is a weird one, Melissa. What can you tell us about where this attack originated from? You know, normally when there's an email, there are these sort of digital breadcrumbs. Do we have any indication who sent this stuff?
Yeah, so when these voters who actually were nice enough to send us these emails that they received got them in their inbox, you saw that it looked like it came from the Proud Boys. And when you looked at that from information field there, the email address was info@officialproudboys.com. We took it a little bit step further and actually looked at some of the source code that is associated with these emails and found that they were being routed through servers in countries like Saudi Arabia, the UAE, and Estonia. In one case, we also had a cybersecurity expert look into this as well to make sure that we were on the right track. And he agreed that it did indeed look like many of these emails were being routed through these servers overseas. He did caution, however, that that does not necessarily mean that the emails are actually coming from servers or people located in these countries. He said that really anybody with an internet connection and a little bit of tech savvy has the ability to use these tools that are out there that would make it look like the emails are coming from a place where indeed they are not.
So does this mean our voting process is not safe from outside influencers as we get closer to the election, like many U.S. leaders suggested earlier this year?
Yeah, well, we've heard from national security and intelligence experts that in terms of the actual voting infrastructure, there really is very little risk in terms of malign actors being able to hack in and change vote tallies, for example. But what we have heard repeatedly is that voters should really be aware of these sophisticated disinformation campaigns that are being mounted by foreign actors in Russia and China and Saudi Arabia, for example. I do want to be clear that when it comes to these emails that many of these voters, many of them Democratic voters, in fact, did receive, there really is no indication at this moment in time that this is stemming from a campaign that is being directed by a foreign actor. It could very well be that it's coming from somebody in the United States. But the cybersecurity experts that we spoke to really warned that voters need to be on high alert, and they also need to be aware that they protect their personal information.
So I'm looking at this example of this email, and they're certainly sort of threatening, you know, we have your personal information, address, and email, and blah, blah, blah. But do they actually have that information?
So a lot of the information that particularly voters in Florida received is actually publicly available through their voter files. So a number of people who sent us their emails, we saw their email address in the body of their email. Their first and last name was included. In some cases, their addresses were included as well. But we did hear from one voter who received an email who said that it did look like the home address that was listed was actually outdated. So it could be an indication that whoever is behind this is actually using information that is taken from the public record. But of course, anyone who is receiving an email such as this that has such threatening language, I think, is of course going to be legitimately concerned.
And Melissa, explain to our audience why this could be problematic for voters who are not so computer savvy.
Yeah, I think for a lot of young voters, of course, it seems like they may not be quite as phased in receiving an email like this, knowing a lot of the technology that is out there and can be manipulated and seized upon in an attempt to scare them. I did speak with one voter in Alachua County, Florida, who said that while she was not very intimidated or phased at all by the email, she did read it out loud to her elderly mother, and she was quite frightened by it. So the concern seems to be that for the elderly in particular, who may not be aware of scams like this or voter intimidation efforts like this, they may actually be compelled to sit out this election and not go to the polls at all, or if they received an email like this that are concerned about potential retaliatory actions, they could also choose to go ahead and follow through on what the email is saying, maybe change their party affiliation, or if they were planning to vote for Joe Biden, cast a vote for President Trump instead.
What about the Proud Boys? Have they responded since these emails are claiming to be coming from the group?
Yeah, my colleague Graham Cates actually spoke with one of the leaders of the Proud Boys last night. He denied any involvement in any of this and seemed actually a little spooked about what was going on, and also reiterated the fact that the concern is that this could really frighten elderly voters who are not aware of similar scams like this.
All right, Melissa Quinn, excellent reporting. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.